So, Jeff, how do you describe to your patients the difference between major depressive disorder, or MDD, and other depressive disorders?
Major depressive disorder is a more severe form of depression, and the person is really impaired much more seriously in terms of their functioning at work or at school or in their relationships with other people, and they're much more withdrawn. And it's a disorder that is called unipolar in the sense that people are either depressed or their mood is normal. And it's the kind of thing that has a genetic basis for it, but usually is triggered by experiences in life, such as loss. It's also different from other disorders that can have other kinds of causes where there's not a genetic tendency toward it. You've seen those kinds of things in practice too, right?
Absolutely. I think other forms of depression that we see commonly are premenstrual dysphoric disorder or PMDD, which is very much a disorder that surrounds a woman's menstrual cycle. In PMDD, patients start feeling mood swings, irritability, tearfulness in the week before the menses starts. These symptoms can be incapacitating. The symptoms begin to improve after the menses begins and then resolve in the week after the menses.
And we have also depressive disorder caused by medical conditions such as stroke or Parkinsonism or medications that people are taking even. And these are all medical conditions that need to be addressed if the person's going to get better, even if you treat the depression. Then you can have also traumatic grief. I saw this in a patient of mine just over the last few weeks who lost his best friend. And he ended up being overwhelmed with grief and went into a depression instead of being able to grieve effectively and move on with his life.
And I think with grief, what distinguishes that from a major depressive episode, although grief can develop into a major depressive episode, in grief or bereavement, when one suffers the loss of a significant person in their life, the grief is intense right at the period of loss, but over time becomes less intense. And yet there will be waves of grief that return upon remembering the loved one. And bereavement do need to be distinguished from major depressive disorder.
One of the things that we know is that people cry a lot when they're depressed. That's one of the symptoms. And with grief, people cry about the loss that they've had. With major depression, people will cry about anything. Doesn't necessarily have to do with any loss, it has to do with the chemistry of their brain. The other thing I was thinking about were those patients who come in and have a low-grade depression, like dysthymia, which is with them all the time, and they don't even realize that it's not normal. But they suffer all the time, and people around them don't even realize that they're suffering because it's not as severe as a major depression, and it's something that can be treated effectively, and people need to know that so that they can seek help and diagnosis and treatment if it's indicated.